in and gotten Charles Davis ready for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a peek at some of the big players in today's game, and you're a big player in today's game as well. Let's get the party started. Here's the kicker, Aldrick Rosas, ready to get us going. And we are underway in Foxborough. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Armadillos ready to go here on first and 10. Brady now on first down. Throw left side, completion to Rice. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. Give him a couple on the catch at second and 8. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
12 yards there as they move the chains. So the offense has it first and 10. QB split out wide now. They're in the Wildcat. And to give this time to the tailback. Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. Past the 20. A big play there. 54 yards on the ground. So down inside the 5-yard line, I have to say, really just a poor job defensively there.
You're exactly right. As a former defensive back, that was not played well at all. But give credit to the offense and give credit to the guy running the football. He gets it down all the way inside the 5.
5 yards to go for the offense. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. A great play there. A 5-yard touchdown run. And this offense takes the ball down the field and scores on their opening drive. And it's good to make it 7-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And, oh, he is really laid out that time. Knocked flat on his back. Ware, and he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. That's it, baby. Just 2 yards to go here on second down for the offense. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
So right now what I'm seeing an offense just firing off the ball a lot quicker than they can react. And not only that, they're sustaining the blocks too. I'm seeing guys get 6-7 yards downfield before there's even a hint of contact.
Throwing on first down is Brady. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
Well, I mean to jump in on you, partner, but they didn't waste any time getting downfield, did they? I mean, a nice big play there.
Three plays, three successful plays in plus territory. Now this defense on its heels a bit.
It seems like they had something targeted there, doesn't it? It's like, okay, we've got a matchup we like coming right out of the gate. Let's go ahead and get right to it.
And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. 12 more yards there and another first down.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield, because I know that when I used to cover.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And he rifles one incomplete. Spencer Ware, the intended target. And it's second down. Well, not to get too overcritical there, because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Now a play fake. Brady finds Chad Johnson on the slant. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. That catch good for five. It's third down.
What terrifies defenses when they see slant routes thrown is that the receiver is on the move, and oftentimes he catches it and gets upfield. Does a really nice job rallying to him and stopping him for a minimal gain.
Dumps that off to Ware. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Spencer Ware, 15 yards. And his guys are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for 6.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They have to make a few additional changes along the way, because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
And a nice gain of 21 yards. Now they try the right side here. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Second down, offense behind the sticks here. Second and 13. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. Back to Foxborough after this. Now some love it, some hate it. Here it is. It's the Wildcat look. Now Brady throwing on second down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. On third and long, it's Brady. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Deshaun Shedd. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
Well, it's third and long, and you've got a few different ways to play it offensively. But this is not the type of offense that's going to wave the white flag. They're going to keep chucking it. And this time, it results in an interception.
By 20! 35!
So after the INT, it's Brady. Caught. It's Cruz, left side. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one goes for 24 yards. On play action, it's Brady. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Brady to throw on second down. Finds a seam inside the 40. And this one complete to Levine Toilolo. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A very solid gain of 27. On first down, Brady. Out on the right, this is Cruz. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. First down now, but that clock rolling. Brady now to throw. And it's caught. Touchdown. Spencer Ware. He scored on the ground and through the air. And his guys have taken the lead.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now, see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. This is taken at his 4. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And incomplete. An excellent play downfield. Should have been picked off, really. But second down instead. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes his quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance.
Oh, he can't get away, and Brady will go down. Chris Long in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. On third down. That's Sanders. It's a room to maneuver. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. Well, Larry, I know it's late there in Orlando. This is a school night. Folks eager to get right back to the action here in the third quarter. This is fielded at the goal line. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And hard running's gonna get him over the 40 to the 42. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
some of the most unselfish players on any football team? Defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
Here's Brady to throw. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Play clock winding down. On first and 10, here's Brady. Cruz has it over the middle. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
On second down, here's Brady. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. He was trying to keep his eyes downfield. Nobody came open.
He's trying to do everything that he had been taught, right? Every bit of the technique. But if no one's open, there is no technique except make sure you hold on to the ball as you go to the ground when you're getting sacked.
Throwing is Brady on third down. He's got Cruz complete. And they'll get 14 yards out of it and a fresh set of downs.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Cruz. And he's into the end zone for the receiving touchdown. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. First and 10, Brady. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. The man with over 1,000 catches, Jason Witten, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down.
And we just saw another example. These cornerbacks have played tight coverage all game long. Might start wanting to think about a few double, triple move routes to try and shake their guys free.
Because they have, you're right, they have had no room to breathe. Second down now after the incompletion. They'll run it now out of the gun. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
They fake the handoff. Now Brady. He's going deep for Brown. And that one incomplete. They try to sneak in a deep ball with the clock running down. But to no avail, as time will expire. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Now Brady, got to have this one. Man open, Rice. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. They got 29 yards there, and it'll give them the first down. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Throwing on first down, Brady. This is caught by Antonio Brown. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
To throw, it's Brady. The swing pass caught, and he gets into the end zone for the touchdown.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field, and that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as a wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control, and how about the end result? A touchdown.
And whistle blown, a timeout here is taken, and it's taken by the kicking team. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And they've got it. They recovered it. But hang on now, though. There's a penalty flag down. So they touched it before it went 10, and that's obviously not going to help their comeback bid here in the fourth.
No, not at all. And they're trying to get something going after one there. But you've got to give yourself a chance. Let it go 10 before you touch it.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get it down to the play to the 37. That one good for 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Now a handoff here to his running back. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gaps, and have the offense hit them with a big play.
They'll turn to the power game, and Ola Wallen. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. And to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
Well, partner, even though my phone alarm failed me this morning and I missed our AM workout, we still made it through this thing together, didn't we?
Well, you always know I need extra workouts just to keep up with you. So it doesn't matter. But thanks for sharing a booth, and thanks for being our quarterback.
Yeah, you're the quarterback. Always a pleasure, my friend. So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. And with that...